What's up, guys? How you doing? It's your boy Josh here, and I'm
Christian.
With Christian. You guys know him from the video. You guys hate him from the video. You guys love him from the video.
Whatever it is, I sleep really good at night.
All right, give him a thumbs up for that. So we're here today. We're going to be talking about photo booth business contracts. Okay, so you guys just started your business and you need to know about contracts, whether you need a contract, whether you should have one, what does it look like, what you should have on there, all those kind of points. So before we get started, tell them a little bit about yourself, your background.
Yeah, so my name is Christian, for those who don't know me. I started my photo booth business in July of last year in the middle of a pandemic. Yes, I said it, in the middle of a pandemic where there was no events happening, where everything was shut down and locked down. The reason why I started my photo booth business is because I actually got laid off back in May from a company called VMA BNSF. But you know, it is what it is. Gotta have a plan, and now I'm here, not only running my own photo booth business on the side, but helping others get their photo booth business started.
And how much you making?
So I make between $6,000 to $8,000. On the lower months, it's about $6,000, $5,000, $6,000. And then on the higher months, it's about $8,500 bucks.
All right. So that's what Christian does. He was a customer with us, and now he decided to come aboard, and he's helping people get started, and he still runs his own photo booth business. Where can they find you online?
They can find me on Instagram, Legacy Booth. You can find me on legacybooth.com. You can find me anywhere, your Facebook, anywhere you need to search up right there. You can find me on Wedding Pro, The Knot, Bark, Thumbtack. I mean, five star Google on Google. You can find me anywhere.
All right, guys. So my name is Josh Pather. If you guys don't know me, so I've been in the photo booth industry now for 10 years, and I've made several millions of dollars renting photo booths. And I'm teaching people now how to start their own photo booth business. And so we're going to be putting this series together to teach you, you know, to learn about the different aspects. So we're going to be covering in this three video series. We're going to be covering CRMs, what apps you need to use to run your photo booth business. This video here, we're going to be talking about contracts for your photo booth business, and then we're going to talk about insurance in the upcoming video. Okay, so make sure to check all the links below. There's a bunch of links for resources and apps and programs. There's discounts for some of them as well, affiliate links, so we get paid on that. But let's get into it. So if you're running any kind of business, it's typical for businesses, especially in the event industry, to get to have a contract. Okay, so we recommend, now if you're a customer with us, you get access to the contract. You can pull it up right on your phone. We have this actually in Spanish as well. So if you're watching this, you need it in Spanish version. That's included inside the PBI Global app. You guys have access to that. So the different parts that we have on here, so I'm gonna cover the different sections that we have. So the first section is basically saying that this is an agreement with the person that you're doing it with. So this will be like your customer's name. It could be like the bride or the event planner or whatever the case is, okay? And then, and it says, and your company. So you have your company name. So Photo Booth Denver LLC or whatever your company name is, that you have your legal company name, okay? And it says for the event taking place at. So you want to put the location of the event, okay? You know, you don't want the billing address, you don't want the house of the groom, you don't want the event planner's house. You need the actual location where you need to show up, okay? So that's in the main part. Then the second part here, and this is all inside the contract that you guys get, okay? If you don't have a contract, you have to buy a booth from us to get access to it. All right. If you already have a booth, go and find the people that sold it to you. They should provide this to you if they want you to be successful. All right. We actually care about your success. We're going to give you everything you need to build your photo booth business. That's why we give you all this. This is actually the same contract that we use doing 800 events a year. Okay. So the next paragraph here. And I'm just skimming over these. These are not actual details. These are just the important fields that we need to have filled in. All right, so the service period, this will be from what to what, okay? So from 5 to 8, from 9 to 11, from 8 to 12, all right? It's very specific. And then right after that, it says, we'll arrive approximately 30 to 45 minutes at our discretion. Now, this is very short notice, guys, and we do this on purpose, just in case we're running late. Because if you show up early and they're expecting you to show 30 minutes before, then it looks good on you. All right, so the next thing here is gonna be your payment. So the payment, the retainer, some people charge $99, some people charge $50. How much do you charge?
$150.
$150.
Non-refundable.
Non-refundable, okay. So some people are gonna get weary about that. If not, don't worry about it, it's all good. Then the next one, date changes and cancellation. So you put your cancellation policy on there. If, you know, obviously with COVID and stuff, we need to kind of be mindful of that. We like to be very flexible. If they book us and they say, hey, we need to move it, we won't give them a refund. We'll move that date to a better time that works for
them. That fits their needs.
That fits their needs, okay? And then some of the more legal stuff here, I'm just gonna skim over because you need to, every state is different for laws. You wanna get this covered in your own state and make sure that it's good for your state, that you can hold it up. Damage to provider's equipment, indemnification, limitation of liability, model release options, an option to tell your customer, like, hey, can we use these photos on social media? Some people don't like that. Mm-hmm. All right, so you need to make sure you have that option, yes or no, okay? Miscellaneous terms, and this, you can, you know, whatever miscellaneous terms you want to have for your company is fine. Billing information, okay? Billing information is like, who do we send the bill to if we can't run the credit card, or who's actually paying for this? We need the address, the phone number, the email, and you know, obviously the name. All right, the venue information, guys, very important. Okay, who's the contact person at the venue, the name of the venue, the street address, the contact email, and then the parking and loading situation for the venue.
That's right? Very important. Why? Because the bride, let's say you talk to the bride, she books you 6 months before. And what's gonna happen is she's not gonna have time to be on her phone on her wedding day. So it's very important to get that information beforehand and call them. I usually call them about 3 days before to say, hey, I'm with Legacy Photo Booth. I just wanna make sure that everything's set. I'm gonna be, it's gonna be easy to unload and load. And most importantly, you got my spot ready, right? Because you don't wanna get to a place where there's tables all over and you gotta do all this labor work and make sure that everything's ready so that you can come in, easy transition out.
All right, guys, next one, we got the layout. We like to put the layout of the photo on there. What do you want it to say? What colors do you want it to be? What type of font? Then the next page is gonna be the invoice. So it's gonna say 2 hour photo booth rental, $750. Once again, reiterate the date and time on there. And then you're gonna have the cost on the right-hand side. Fuel surcharge, I like to charge $10 for fuel surcharge, a little bit of extra cash to help you out with fuel. Then you have your subtotal, your sales tax, and then your deposit. So you minus the deposit, then you got the balance left of what they owe you. We take the balances the week off the event, all right? You don't wanna walk up to the bride while they're walking down the aisle or cutting the cake and asking them like for payment, all right? You don't wanna do that. And then we've got additional notes in the bottom. This is space, power, and internet access, okay? So space, we need a 10 by 10 area, we need a power outlet, and if you want uploads to social media, you need to have Wi-Fi access, or you can rent our Wi-Fi for $20 an event, and then that pays for the Wi-Fi, okay? And then at the bottom here, we got tip, we get the tips ahead of time. It says, hey, do you wanna leave a tip for your attendant? They can do that, and then the credit card information. So the credit card, all the stuff that's, you know, for the credit card number, expiration date, security code, zip code. And then just some other little tips on here. We don't set up the canopy outside. You know, if it's an outside event and it starts raining, we need to move inside, that kind of stuff. And this can be like ever growing, okay? So if you start off with a simple contract and over the time you run into issues, then you change the contract up every time. And then we make sure to send it through an online application. You guys can use Honeybook. We are sponsored by Honeybook. You can see a link below to get Honeybook, which is an awesome photo booth app to run your company. That's what Christian uses. Yeah. And
super easy, super, it's like literally changed the game. Yeah. Changed the game for me.
Yeah. Have you run into any problems with your contract?
No, I use the PBIs, the one that you have on PBI University.
Yeah.
Download it there, and then I just changed it up according to what I see fit. I added a few things like, I have more than 3 hours, food must be provided for the attendants because it could be there between 3 to 4 hours.
Yeah.
Want to make sure that they're well fed. And if for whatever reason they can't, you know, it's okay. You know, that's where I feed my employees, make sure that they're well taken care of. But all usually right. I don't have any problems with that.
All right, guys, that's going to be it. We're going to wrap it up here. The camera is dying, unfortunately, but if you have more questions, comment below. Make sure to subscribe to our channel. Hit the thumbs up so we can bring you more videos if you guys found some value in that. Make sure to reach out to us at Photobooth INT. Catch Photobooth Boss on there. We'll see you next time. Bye. Peace.